In this video, I'll show you how to get your data feed in tip-top shape, which will get even more of your products online and make it easier for searching shoppers to find you. If you see issues with your data feed, three main things might be the culprit: feed processing, data quality, and policy violations. Let's dive in. Get started by logging into your Merchant Center account and visiting Products and then Diagnostics in the side panel. This is where you'll see which items or products are under review, which are active or expiring, and which need fixing. The Feeds card lists issues that prevents us from processing an entire feed, such as upload or fetch issues. Click into the Feeds tab and into your affected feed to learn more about what the issue may be so you can resolve the errors. Now let's talk about data quality around specific items that may be disapproved in your feed. Accurately describing your items and reflecting the products on your site at all times will make it easier for shoppers to find what they're looking for. You'll want to submit high-quality images so potential customers can see your product shine. They should have a light, solid background and be focused on the items. Images 800 by 800 pixels or a bit larger are best. Images should be free of watermarks, banners, or promotional copy, and be saved in one of our supported formats. Also, be sure to test your image URLs to make sure they're working properly. You may see errors if your data feed contains unrecognized or invalid attributes or is missing required attributes. Double-check that you've filled out all of the required fields in your data feed to resolve these errors. Information such as price and availability also has to match your site, so be sure to regularly update your feed to reflect the freshest information. If these change frequently, you can use supplemental feeds, a secondary feed with a subset of attributes, to make quick updates without having to resubmit your entire feed. Next up, we'll talk policy violations. When your products aren't in line with Google shopping policies, specific items, or your account as a whole could be suspended. In most cases, you'll get an email explaining which items have been suspended and why. You'll also see a notification in your Merchant Center account. To avoid this, there are a few steps you can take. Make sure you're familiar with items that aren't permitted for sale on Google. You must also follow professional business practices, including making sure your landing pages are not broken or under construction. Show your customers the payment methods accepted and your accurate business contact information prior to checking out. And have a functional and easy to identify buy button. Finally, make sure to have a straightforward and secure checkout process. The quickest way to fix a violation is to remove all violating items from the feed or excluding the program that this product shows on by using the excluded underscore destination attribute. If a product is incorrectly disapproved for a policy violation, you may be able to request a manual review in Merchant Center. Go to Diagnostics to see your Item Issues tab and scroll down to view samples of your product disapprovals. Then, click into a product to view more details. If eligible, click Request Review under the Item Status section of the product page. Once you confirm the offer complies with Google shopping policies and product feed specifications, tick the box and click Request Manual Review. Lastly, you can check above your diagnostics table to see when it was last refreshed. Make sure your data feed is healthy and you're all set. Now shoppers can see what you have and find what they're looking for, which will help lead to more sales.